So the take home message here is big lake to us, to a shrimp salmon, not big lake at all. Not big at all. And before these fish decide to go back to where they're stocked or raising the pen, before they home, basically the lake is a small jump for them to go across. And he's going to talk more about that. So in summary, we're getting more bang for the buck on our stockfish. There's a lot more fish surviving, even though we kept our stocking levels at the same level. Putting more fish in the pens, we're getting more fish surviving. We're also getting a lot of wild fish, as you've heard before. We've increased the number of fish in pens in Ontario. As I mentioned before, we have 700,000 fish in our pens. Almost 200,000 in Ontario and 500,000 in New York. Chinooks were smaller in 2015, however, they were still small. They still had pretty good fat content. They weren't looking skinny. Catch rates were down. And from an outlook perspective for 2016, it does seem as though there were fewer chinooks in the lake in 2014. They ran late, but they did that all the way across the Great Lakes. That was a basin-wide phenomenon due to the weather patterns. However, when they did run late, we did see fewer chinooks in the tributaries. We were able to get all the eggs we needed for our Salmon River hatchery. We had no problem meeting our egg target. But in terms of annual success, it was all in the tributaries as well. So question marks for 2016, I guess we're hoping for a normal summer in terms of weather patterns, so that at least that will not play into the catch rates. And we'll have a better idea about whether the catch rates in 2016 actually reflect the abundance of fish, or if they're going to continue this pattern that we had in 14 and 15, where things really threw things off. So with that, do we have time for questions now?
You know what? I'll give you